Lindsay here, the Frugal Crafter. Have you ever found some stamp sets that you just absolutely think are fun and cute and a little weird, but then you get them and you don't know what to do with them? Well, today I'm going to show you how I handled that situation. And when I saw these new stamps from our sponsor, TopFlightStamps.com, I knew I had to make some cards with them, but I was really confused as to what I was going to make. I mean, look at the ostrich head and feet. They are so cute. These are some of their Quetzalcraft stamps, because TopFlightStamps.com travels the world, finds the coolest stamps all over the globe, and brings them back to us here in the United States. So when I was looking at these weird, funny animals, I thought kids cards, that would be great. And then I thought, oh, it'd be so great to send cards that had puns or jokes. And I did some searching online and I found a treasure trove of funny puns and jokes for these cards. And you can do it too. Just search whatever animal stamp you have and search pun or joke and you will find some really cool ideas. So hopefully this inspires you to use your stamps, especially if you've got some cute Quetzalcraft ones that you want to craft with. And then these are great to send to kids that you know, or immature adults like me. So without further ado, let's get to the project. I'll have all of the things I used today linked down below so you can find them easily, and let's do some crafting. Here's a close look at the stamps we're going to use today. We have this cute ostrich head and feet, which are designed to go together. And then we have a couple of weird animal stamp sets that were really cute, but I had a hard time figuring out what I wanted to do. I thought that it'd be fun to stamp these with archival ink on watercolor paper so that I could use some just kind of bright, splashy, water-based markers on them. And I'm using a hot press watercolor paper. And what that means is that the paper is smooth. So it's going to give you all the properties of watercolor paper, which means you can use water-based markers or watercolor and it's not going to warp or pill the paper, but you've got a smooth surface. If you don't have hot press watercolor paper or you can't find it, try using smooth Bristol board. That's kind of like a cardstock weight watercolor paper. Well, it's definitely watercolor compatible paper, and make sure you use ink that's not going to bleed. Now I'm using some water-based markers, and these are the kind that have the real brush bristles on them, which is really easy to blend. So I put that black down and now I'm able to blend it out with some peach. It's just really easy to use on this type of paper or on Bristol because the marker ink stays on the surface and then you blend it out. Now this is for water-based markers only. If I was using alcohol markers, I wouldn't want to use this type of paper because it would suck up too much ink and I wouldn't be able to blend it. So whenever you're starting a crafting project, make sure you choose the right supplies that go together. I'm going to time lapse the rest of this coloring just so you can see how it's done, but so it doesn't take all day. I really enjoy putting in the darker color, like on this ostrich. I thought I would try some kind of bright, bold colors because I stamped it twice. So I figured, well, I can do one bright and bold and I can do one more natural. And I love that you can just put down a little color and then blend it out with the next color. It's very forgiving. So if you've been frustrated with your water-based markers, try that. Try Bristol paper or hot press watercolor paper. Now the hot press watercolor paper I'm using today and is my favorite for this technique is the 90 pound Fabriano Studio hot press watercolor paper. It comes in pads of 75 sheets and it's pretty affordable. I think it's around between $20 and $30 depending if you get a 9 by 12 pad, which I'd recommend because you can trim that in your regular paper trimmer, or a 12 by 18 inch pad, which it's nice and it's probably a little bit cheaper per square inch, but it can be difficult if you don't have a big enough paper trimmer to accommodate it. And because it's 90 pound, I can put this in my scan and cut machine and I can cut out these images easily. Now, as expected, I could cut out all of the animals, all of the images here with my scan and cut machine, except for the ostrich, because of all the little hairy, fluffy feathers on the side. There's like areas where there's no distinct line. So my scan and cut could not cut out the ostrich heads. I had to cut those out by hand, but all the other ones, it cut really well. So that's one thing you have to think about if you're considering a scan and cut machine, which is a digital die cutter that that you just scan your page in and it cuts around things. If you don't have a solid border, if there's not a solid line around your whole image, it's not going to cut it very well. So that's just something to keep in mind. It doesn't work so well if I'm like building a scene using different colored inks. It works much better if I have like a black outline. So you can see I've got that nice white outline on the other animals. I cut them out with my scan and cut, and I decided to leave that border because I thought it looks kind of like a sticker and it would be appealing for children. And then I'm just doing my best, friends, at cutting out this ostrich by hand. I'm not the best with scissors, but I think it looks pretty cute anyway. We're gonna start off with the ostrich card, and I'm gonna make a 6x6 card because that stamp with the feet and the head were kind of big, and I wanted to have plenty of room for my my elements and also the joke that I wanted to put on the card. So I took a piece of 6x6 pattern paper, and it had a kind of like a circle pattern on it, and I cut a 4-inch circle from the center. I also trimmed down that paper so I'd have a little bit of a border on my 6x6 card, and by tracing the circle that I die cut, I'm going to show exactly where I will do any decorating. I wanted to make a fun background that wouldn't distract from that pretty coloring that I did and the cute stamping. So I'm taking some Prism ink in kind of a seafoam green color, and I'm using a blending brush to cover that area with a nice soft coating of color. I'm just being careful to go just beyond the circle that I drew because I don't want to get that color onto the outside border. I've got the overlay I will glue down later, but I do want that border of the card to be nice and bright. So I'm just trying to keep my coloring on the inside of the circle. Next, I'm going to do some stenciling using a foam tip applicator, that same color of ink, and the leftover piece from the die cuts that I made to embellish this card with. So whenever you can repeat an element, it usually will look really nice on your card and also really chic. Even though this is a fun card for kids, this is a technique you can use over and over again. So the same color stenciled over the brushed color does give you enough contrast for that to show up. And I figure repeating that element over again is just going to really add to the bird theminess of this project. After I had all my feathers stenciled and I let it dry, I am taking a little bit of water and just flicking it over there. Now this is Prism ink. You can also use Distress ink. You can use Distress Oxide inks. You could use Harmony ink pads. Any ink pad that you have that is reactive with water is going to work well for this. The cardstock I'm using is not very expensive. It is the Park Lane Heavyweight 12x12 cardstock from Joann's, and I'm just using half sheet. But if you have the hot press watercolor paper or Bristol cardstock, you could use that as well. I tend not to use that for card bases just because it's a little bit more expensive, but if you don't often make large cards like this, it's probably less money just to use a sheet of that. I really love the effect that you get. Now make sure that's really dry before you go on to the next step, which is to stamp over with another reactive ink. Actually, you can use any type of ink for this. Sorry for my head being in the way there, but I wanted to stamp straight down over the top so that my Starburst stamp, also from Quetzalcraft, will be right in the middle of this shape here. So I'm really pushing down well because I want to make sure I get a really good impression, and there we've got that all layered up. Now the feathers look very subtle underneath that stamp, but we're going to do that stenciling on the inside of the card, so it's all going to work together for a cohesive look. Now let's put this bad boy together. We're gonna take the overlay piece, and you might need to turn it a couple times to make sure you have it in the right spot when you originally drew your pencil line, because you know, as good as we try, cutting something directly in the center can be challenging. So I made sure I had it lined up just the right way, and then I set down my elements there to kind of figure out how I wanted to glue everything down. I ended up going with the ostrich that was a little bit more natural in color versus the one that was a little psychedelic in color, because I thought it looked more comical that way to have a realistic looking ostrich on this kind of crazy colorful card. But you can do whatever you want because your cards are your cards. You can use different stamps, you can use different colors, you can use different papers. It's all up to you. Now I like having the feet kind of poking out of the edges of the hole, and I like having the neck kind of up underneath. So it's like you don't see any disconnected body parts. You know, you can just kind of imagine the big fluffy ostrich butt up above it. And for adhering everything down, for my larger pieces, I will use my tape runner. And then for the skinnier pieces, I will use just plain white glue. Now I tried to go in and erase the pencil markings, but just like with watercolor, once you get some ink down on top, it really does prevent it from erasing. So that didn't really work out so well, but luckily my pieces all lined up. If you're using wet glue, you do have a little bit of time to adjust things when you're sticking it down, just so you know. But if you get any of that glue kind of seeping out around your images that you're gluing down, if you can wipe that up quickly with a paper towel, that should keep you from getting any like glossy spots or snail trails on your card. Just a clean paper towel. I would blot it first, and if that doesn't take care of it, just very, very gently rub it. And then everything should be fine. If I have a larger area, like this ostrich, I might just use double-sided adhesive, or I might put a strip of double-sided adhesive down and then put a little bit of white glue as well if I have some areas that I think are gonna stick up but are too small to use the adhesive on. By putting down some tape like that and then adding drops of glue, the tape kind of clamps it while it's drying. So that's a neat little tip to keep in mind if you're ever in that situation where you've got some really weird shaped stamped image, like skinny arms or legs or something that you can't use double-sided tape on. I cut a bunch of feathers out of some coral and brown pattern paper just to embellish my card with, and that's where the stencil came from that we used at the beginning. I just saved it after I cut out the coral cardstock feathers, and I'm just placing them around to try to put them in a pleasing arrangement. And then for the sentiments, all I did was I went online, looked for ostrich puns, and put them in a Google Doc, and then printed a bunch out at once, and then just trimmed them apart with my paper trimmer. I inked the edge with that same foam brush or foam sponge that I stenciled with, and there's the front of the card. I'll show you another way to embellish at the end, but this is where we are right now. Did you hear about the ostrich that was arrested? They let him go. They didn't think he was a flight risk. Waka waka waka. I love it. I think it's so funny. You might think it's cheesy. Well, here you can see I'm just trimming the strips down so they fit in the card, and you can cut up any of the words so that they go a little bit better. Like I suggest cutting at like commas and whatnot. I think it's cute to ink the edges and glue them down kind of staggered. I think it just adds to the silliness of it, I guess, and it's just so fun. You can also use the ink pad to ink the edges, whatever is easier for you, really. You just go with that, and don't worry about a smudge or a smear. It doesn't have to be perfect. You know, send these off to your friends, to your relatives. I think they will definitely get a kick out of it, especially in the days that we are in now. To add a little more pizzazz to the inside of the card, I'm going to do some more stenciling with that feather stencil. And you know what? I actually kept this. I stuck it right in the little packet with that ostrich and feet stamp set. And I also put any leftover feathers and things like that that I die cut so I could have them for the next time that I want to make a card with these stamps, because I did cut extra feathers. When I'm doing die cutting and preparing for a card, I often will cut more than I need because I just don't know exactly how many I'm going to use. And then the leftovers can just be used and saved with that stamp set and used in another project. I also do the same thing when I am stamping out images. Often I stamp out more than I need for a project, and then I just take those images and I stick them right in the envelope that the stamp set comes in. It saves time and it makes for a quick card in the future. If I'm kind of short on time, I've got something colored and ready to go. So keep that in mind when you are crafting. Then after I had as many blue stencils as I wanted put down, I went ahead and glued on a few leftover feathers, finishing the inside of this card. Isn't it absolutely adorable? Next up, we have this cute bunny card with the joke, how do you catch a unique rabbit? Unique up on it. How do you catch a tame rabbit? Tame way. So I'm starting off with a hot pink card base to complement my pink bunny, and I'm adding on a panel of a kind of baby blue pattern paper. And I selected the pattern paper because it had little bunnies and it was very springtime-ish, and I thought it would be really kind of cute and childlike. And yeah, maybe the colors clash a little bit, the pastel colors with the hot pink and the bright colors in the bunny, but know your audience. This is for kids, and I think it's going to be super fun for a kid to get that in the mail. I like to mix my pattern papers, so I tore off a piece of the little bunny pattern because I really thought that went with the theme well, and I just adhered it over the edge. This is going to separate the front into two portions, one portion for my image and one portion for the sentiment, which I'm cutting down from a strip, and I'm just building along the right side of the card. I decorated the inside of the card by using some little journal notes that came in that same pad of pattern paper and scraps, and cut down the punchline of the sentiment strips and glued those down as well. Here's a look at the finished card and the inside. The last two cards we're going to put together pretty quickly because it's more the same. We're just layering up pattern paper. This circle was actually the leftover piece from the ostrich card. I'm putting that in the middle of a teal background. I'm putting it a little bit below center so that I'll have room for the first part of the joke on the top. And I'm using my tape runner for adhering since everything is nice and big. So that works out really well. And I just put the sentiment on top, where do sheep go to get their wool cut? And on the inside, the Baba shop. Get it? Ba. And for our last joke card, I'm just layering up some other pattern papers. Now, before I colored everything, I did get an idea of what I was going to use for pattern paper, so I would know my coloring would be somewhere in the ballpark. I'm layering up these kind of very kid-themed papers, and this funny rat, which was so fun to color. But where does a rat go to get his tail replaced? The retail store. And I put a tag on the inside of the card just to kind of hammer that punchline home. For a final frugal embellishment on these cards, I'm simply going through some paper scraps, like leftover cutoffs from the cards are perfect, and I punched some circles. And then I just laid them down on the cards to figure out what ones I wanted to use, and for the ones I wanted to use, I used a foam pad and a ball and stylus to rub on the back of them, and that makes like little faux enamel dots. Now you could emboss them with heat, like with a clear embossing powder, and make them shiny, but I decided to just glue them down as is for a little bit of textured embellishment on each of the cards. I think it's a subtle way just to add a little bit of dimension, and it's not going to add any postage or anything to your cards. Now keep in mind, square cards do take an extra 12 cents postage, I think, if mailed in the United States, or you can put them in a larger envelope that is normal. But there's a final look at the cards. I love the dimension of the little faux enamel dots. Remember, you could use some glossy accents or clear embossing powder on them if you want to make them shine a little bit more. For the small dots, I just used white glue to glue them down. For the big ones, I did use a drop of hot glue, but you do have to be careful not to let them, not to let the glue seep out. I hope you enjoyed today's tutorial, and if you did, please leave me a thumbs up. I'll have all the stamps I used linked down to our sponsor, topflightstamps.com, in the video description, so check them out if you want any of these stamps, and there's a coupon code to save you some money on your order. Thanks for watching. Until next time, happy crafting!